Welcome to new video from Talent Battle. In this video, we are going to solve some questions which are frequently asked for CoCubes test. We have already created one video in which we have shared details about CoCubes, MCAT, Elitmus and TCSI on CCQT. I have added a link in the description box so you can watch that video later if you have not watched it yet. Now, let us start with the questions. Before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, do subscribe to our channel to receive the latest updates from campus placement. So now let's check the first question. To earn extra profit, a shopkeeper mixes 30 kg of dal purchased at rupees 36 per kg and 26 kg of dal purchased at rupees 20 per kg. What will be the profit that he will make if he sells the mixture at rupees 30 per kg? So this particular question belongs to profit loss. Okay, to solve this question, what we can do? So the first thing which we need to check is total cost price, because in the end they have asked us to calculate what will be the profit. Okay, so as we know, the formula for profit is nothing but selling price minus cost price. So first let us calculate what is total cost price. Okay, so total cost price is nothing but, in this case, a shopkeeper mixes 30 kilogram of dal purchased at rupees 36. So in that case, cost price will be 30 kg into 36 rupees per kg and 26 kilogram of dal purchased at 20 rupees per kg. So I can say 26 into 20. So total cost price in that case will be 1080 plus 520. That will be 1600. So cost price in this case is 1600. Now what they have mentioned, if he sells the mixture at rupees 30 per kg. So 34 per kg, so total selling price will be, in that case, he is selling that mixture at 30 rupees per kg. But total mixture is of how many kilograms? So as you can check, 30 kilogram and 26 kilograms. So total mixture is of 56 kilograms. So selling price in that case will be 30 rupees per kg into total 56 kilograms. So that will be 1680 rupees. So as they have asked you profit, profit is nothing but selling price minus cost price. So 1680 minus 1600, answer is going to be 80 rupees. So answer is B. Check this question. A sum was put at simple interest at certain rate for 3 years. Had it been put at 1% higher rate, it would have fetched rupees 63 more. The sum is. Okay. So in this question, they have basically asked us principal. As we know, the basic formula for simple interest is simple interest is equal to PRT divided by 100. In which P is principal, rate of interest, time divided by 100. Okay. So what they have mentioned? A sum was put at simple interest at a certain rate for 3 years. So timing they have mentioned as 3. Had it been put at 1% higher rate. So they have not directly mentioned rate of interest. So we need to consider initial rate of interest as R only. And later on we need to consider new rate of interest as R plus 1. So just first put all the values in the formula. So what they have said, sum was put at simple interest at certain rate for 3 years. So we don't know principal, I will keep it as P only. Rate of interest also we don't know, so I will keep it as R. And timing was 3 years divided by 100. And in that case, we don't know simple interest as well. So let me put it just as SI only. So this is the first equation. Now, what will happen to the second equation? Had it been put at 1% higher rate. So now new rate of interest is R plus 1. So in that case, it would have fetched 63 more. So simple interest, new simple interest will be previous simple interest plus 63. So equation in that case will be SI plus 63 is equal to principal will be same. New rate of interest will be R plus 1 and timing will be same, which is 3 divided by 100. And now ultimately we want to find out P. So using these two equations, okay, first equation and second equation, we need to find out value of P. So what we can do, from first equation, we are already having a value of SI. Just let's put that value in this particular equation where SI is equal to P into R into 3 divided by 100. So let me put it over here. It will be 3PR divided by 100 plus 63. is equal to, let me simplify this, 3PR plus 3 into P into 1. So that will be 3P divided by 100. Okay, so if I simplify this, 3PR plus 6300 divided by 100 is equal to 3PR plus 3P divided by 100. Okay, 100 and 100 will get cancelled. 3PR and 3PR will get cancelled. What will remain? 3P is equal to 6300. And the value of P will be 6300 divided by 3 is 2100. P is nothing but the principal or the sum which they have asked. So answer will be B in this particular case. A company named Deona Automobiles has received an order for 5000 widgets for a total sale price of $5,000 and wants to determine the gross profit that will be generated by completing the order. The other details for producing 1 lakh widgets are given as follows. Raw materials cost $10,000. Direct labor costs $50,000. So they have given us an idea how much it costs to produce 1 lakh widgets. So we need to think about how much it will take to produce 5,000 widgets. Okay, so let's start. First, let us check what they have mentioned. To produce 1 lakh widgets, okay, let me write it over here. Basically, the cost has been divided in two parts. Okay, first part, as you can check, it is raw material. And second part is direct labor cost. Okay, so for 1 lakh widgets, what has happened? The raw material cost is $10,000. Okay, and direct labor cost is $50,000. So what we need to understand, since they have asked us to calculate it for 5000 widgets, okay, and the selling price in that case is $5,000, okay, so we need to calculate a profit. So already we know selling price, we need to calculate what will be the cost price. So if for 1 lakh widgets this is the cost price, so what will be the cost price for 5000 widgets? Again, it will be divided in two parts: raw material cost and direct labor cost. Okay, so as you can check, 5000 is nothing but when we divide 1 lakh by 20, we will get 5000. So similarly for raw material, if the cost is 10,000, just divide it by 20. So 10,000 divided by 20, that will be cost for 5000 widgets. Similarly for direct labor cost, 50,000 is the total price for 1 lakh widgets. So for 5000 widgets, it will be divided by 20. So just calculate, 10,000 divided by 20 is nothing but $500 for raw material in the case of 5,000 widgets, and for direct labor cost, it will be $2,500. Okay, dollars. So to produce 5,000 widgets, the total cost is raw material $500 and direct labor cost is $2,500. So total cost is $3,000. So this is cost price. Selling price they have already mentioned is $5,000. So the question is very easy. They have just asked you profit. Profit is nothing but selling price minus cost price. So $5,000 minus $3,000. Answer is going to be $2,000. Now let's check interesting question. If m is equal to 2 minus root 3, then the value of m raised to 6 plus m raised to 4 plus m square plus 1 divided by m raised to 3 is. Okay, so let's try to solve this question. First, let us write down this equation: m raised to 6 plus m raised to 4 plus m square plus 1 divided by m cube. So to simplify this, I will write it like m raised to 6 divided by m cube plus m raised to 4 divided by m cube plus m square divided by m cube plus 1 divided by m cube. Okay, so if I simplify this, what will remain? M raised to 6 divided by m raised to 3, that will be m raised to 3, this will be m, this will be 1 by m plus 1 by m square. Okay, now out of this, if you check, we already have values for m, and you can also use it for 1 by m. We need to calculate the value for m cube and m square. So to find out ultimately this particular value of this expression, we need to find out value of this expression. Okay, so how we can find out this expression? First, let us calculate what is m cube. Okay, now in this equation, they have given m is equal to 2 minus root 3. Okay, so if I decide to find out m cube, that will be 2 minus root 3 bracket raised to q. Okay, so for this you need to use the formula of a minus b raised to 3. Now what is the formula for a minus b raised to 3? Okay, let me write it over here. A minus b raised to 3, it is a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square. This is the formula which is used for a minus b raised to 3. So let us just use those value or use that formula over here. M cube is equal to a cube, that will be 8, minus b cube means root 3 into root 3 into root 3. So that will be 3 root 3. Okay, if I make a cube of root 3, that will be 3 root 3. Now the next thing will be minus 3a square b. So minus 3 a square b means a is nothing but value of 2, so that will be 2 raised to 2, that will be 4, and root 3 will be as it is. So I will just write it over here like this, and then what will happen, plus 3ab square, so plus 3 a will be as it is, b square will be root 3 square, so that will be 3. Now let us solve this. 8 minus 3 root 3, and over here 3 into 4, 12, 12 root 3, plus 3 into 2 into 3, so that will be 18. So 18 plus 8, 26, minus 3 root 3 minus 12 root 3, it is nothing but minus 15 root 3. So now I am having a value of m cube, which is 26 minus 15 root 3. Okay, so this is clear. Now the next thing which I need to calculate, already I am having a value of m and m cube. Now let us calculate what is 1 by m. 1 by m is nothing but 1 by 2 minus root 3, right? To make a simple calculation, what I will do, I will multiply these equation in numerator and denominator by 2 plus root 3. Okay, 2 plus root 3. Now what will happen? Okay, let's calculate. If I multiply this by 2 plus root 3, 2 plus root 3 will come in numerator, and in denominator this will be a minus b and a plus b. Okay, so a minus b, a plus b is nothing but a square minus b square. So 2 square is 4 minus root 3 square is 3. So 2 plus root 3 divided by 1, it will be 2 plus root 3. So value for 1 by m will be 2 plus root 3. Okay, and value for m cube was this. Now the next thing which we need to do, 1 by m cube, this should have been 1 m cube. So as you can check over here, it is 1 by m cube. So we need to find out value of 1 by m cube. We already know value of m cube, which is 26 minus 15 root 3. So to make calculation easy, what I will do, again I will multiply this with 26 plus 15 root 3 divided by 26 plus 15 root 3. Okay, so what will happen, 26 plus 15 root 3 divided by a square minus b square, 26 square is nothing but 676, minus 15 square is 225, root 3 is into 3. Okay, so if you check, this is going to be 26 plus 15 root 3 divided by 676 minus 675. So value of 1 by m cube will be 26 plus 15 root 3, because in denominator I will be having 1. Now we have already calculated all the values, just let us put those values in this equation. M cube, m cube is 26 minus 15 root 3 plus m, value of m is 2 minus root 3, plus 1 by m, value of 1 by m is 2 plus root 3. Okay, and value of 1 by m cube, which is 26 plus 15 root 3. So minus 15 root 3 plus 15 root 3 will get cancelled. Root 3 minus root 3 will get cancelled. So what will remain? 26 plus 2, 28. 28 plus 2, 30. 30 plus 26 is 56. So answer for this question is going to be 56. Recently, we have launched a complete preparation package for all the major assessment companies like CoCubes, Elitmus, etc. If you want more details, I have added a link in the description box. If you like this particular video, do like and share it with your friends. Do not forget to join our Telegram group and as well as Instagram page to get the recent updates about any campus placement drive. Thank you.